Hello everyone, and welcome to another Murktide video. This is the first video after Violent Outburst ban, which doesn't mean that the Cascade decks are dead, but it does mean that Murktide gets a much better matchup against them. A lot of the Tomb of Rhinos versus Murktide matchup was the dancing around instant speed threat. Now, Ardent Plea and Shardless are sorcery speed. Same thing for Living End, which definitely gets weakened by the inability of going Outburst plus Force of Negation. As much as people said that Murktide was favored against Cascade, he wasn't. He was always very, very close, especially against Living End. So yeah, I'm just glad that those two decks are less popular and less powerful, so that Murktide can be a little bit better against them. This is my current list, and it has 1 Pick the Poison main, 2 in the side, very, very strong card. I also decided to try a little bit of Questing Druid. Don't want to play too many, because the metagame is still very, very combo-oriented, so you don't have too much time to dirtle around with Questing Druid. And you have a Breeding Pool, so I think it's a free roll to play only one. I could play more, but I don't mind playing one. It's not a card, you have to play more copies. This is like the fifth copy of Iteration, basically. What else is it too worth sharing? Underworld Breach. This card is very important. Post-sideboard against 4-color Omnat and for Yawgmoth. Both decks have Pick the Poison now to kill your Murktide. It's much more unreliable than before. You need the card advantage tool of Underworld Breach. Although, obviously, they have Endurance, so... yeah, you can counter that, so... there's that. Yeah, not too much else to say. Soga Lantern is here for Goryeo's Vengeance, which is very popular now. One Thundering Falls. Again, if you haven't listened to the episode I recorded with Twinless Twin about this deck, go listen to it. It's episode 17 on every podcast platform to Competitive Magic with the Carnies or on my YouTube channel. But yeah, outside of that, let's go. Let's play some Murktide action. I still have to decide my deck for the LMS in Prague happening next week. She's very, very close. No Shredder. Yeah, no Shredder. No Shredder. I didn't even play Shredder in Ghent when maybe I should have. Now that Rhinos is slightly better matchup, I definitely don't want Shredder, no. And also Pick the Poison made Shredder even worse. I remember playing against Murktide and I just killed a Shredder with Pick Your Poison. It felt I was like even a large Shredder. It wasn't a 1-3. It's like a 3-5. On the play. Opponent has Giganta. So much Zoo these days. My league previously I played against 2 Zoo decks, and now Giganta Leyline. Yeah, I mean, we're on the play, so we can counterspell the Sign of Draco. If you're on the draw and they play Sign of Draco, it's just over. Alright, 1 mana, 3-3. Very, very tough matchup here. Taco de Nakato, and you pass. Okay. All right, I'll play my third Volcanic Island. Sodo. Epip Day. Oh, is it 314? It is. You're the first one that's saying that today. It's 314. How do you say that in English? Greek P? We say that Greek P. P Greco. Oh, you say Greek pie? Or you just don't even say Greek? Just say pie. Crazy. Pie? Why would you say just pie? Alright. Okay, I drew Ragavan. I think I want to have lands rather than going iteration. Yeah. Iteration is like very far away from getting me Delirium. Opponent, can you give me a Lightning Bolt, please? I said please. You give me a Ragavan. Nah, I don't want it. Actually, it gives me Delirium, maybe. It fills the graveyard. Maybe it's not that bad. Maybe it's not that bad. I'll keep yours. Put things in the graveyard. Give me Delirium. Maybe I have to use the treasure to play Counterspell. Yes. But I think it's okay. Greek pi squared. Yeah, pi greco. And so long past since I used that. What was it? Use it again to do the triangle. I don't even know how to say that in English. Triangle space? To count the triangle space? Lato per lato per 3,14. Oh yeah, to calculate the ipotenusa. I don't know the words in English. To calculate this side. Yeah. True. Okay, the Mapone can go sign of Draco, if you do. Oh, okay. Yeah, let's leave this on top. Ipotenusa, it's the same in Italian. Yeah, same. Do side by side, multiply by 3,14. Right. You calculate the potenusa. Okay, now let's go to iteration, finding a fetch land. I'm sure I'll find a fetch land, like, for sure. It's like already there. There it is. And even have Delirium now, because I graveyarded that Ragavan. Okay, I can go hand, bottom, exile. Breeding pool, untapped. I'll play, pick your poison, sacrifice an enchantment. Graveyard. Attack. And then I go murky. So I can't keep Delirium now, but I can next turn play Ragavan and get Delirium again. So I'll exile Ragavan. Yeah, so I don't have Delirium now, but it'll be Delirium next turn. And I'm lethal next turn by playing Ragavan. Anyone here has done Invasion Block Draft on MTGO? Nah, I wasn't. When Invasion was a thing, I was probably, what, like 10 years old? Or even less than that. But it fetches a forest to start and attacks with all. I'll play around Tribal Flames. What is this? Yeah, I'll leave you with Ragavan hit. I just don't want to die to Trouble Flames. They always have Trouble Flames, so. Okay, they hit a land off Ragavan. Trouble Flames, I'm at one. No, you drew another one? You drew it off of Cabo, you drew it. Porca boia. Okay. Zoo. Very good. Very good deck, Zoo. It's gonna be very high in my power ranking this month, Zoo. How's I never really know how to sabre against Zoo? I definitely want Pick Your Poison. So the bad cards are Spell Pierce and Counter Spells, but I don't know if I can afford to side all of these. I think Brotherhood, so clunky. So clunky, Brotherhood. How about Stern Scolding? Stern Scolding also sucks. Doesn't counter anything. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna have Spell Pierce. They always have trouble flames anyway. Is it true that Coffers is kind of good again? I say that Cabal Coffers is one of those romantic deck choices. You ignore its position in the metagame and you play because you love it. It's like people that play Creativity or Blue-White Control. It's just a romantic deck choice. Murktide. We'll just play it. Whereas, like, Espergorio, Leaving Gand, people just play because they want to win. They just sleeve up the tier 1 deck that just wants to do their thing. Okay. Let's go. Land Ragavan. Ooh, the other weekend I bought some Guild Pack Steam Vents, finally. That was the only card I was missing. Now I have the full deck in first edition. Am I shocked? I had zero. I bought three. There was a moment in my life when I, for some reason, liked all the reprints and exchanged a lot of my collection, and now I just have to trade back. And by trade back, I mean just buy the old one. Never sell. Hey, I have Delirium with Preordain. Okay, I also have Delirium with Bauble, so it's much easier. Est in Peperoni. Okay. I want to exile it. Yeah, let's exile it. Preordain. Bolt explosives. I don't want any of those. Wish I played Iteration and not Preordain. I want to play Iteration now. Kind of awkward. A little bit awkward. Play Iteration now. Alright, I'll hold. But yeah, this was not well played. I'm never a fan of cracking a treasure to play Iteration to hit a land drop off of it. It's never a play that I do, unless I'm, like, desperate. And I wasn't desperate. Nah, it's okay. It's okay. It's okay. I'm fine. Could it be better if I played Iteration instead of Preordain, but I'm fine. A lot of Preordains and Iteration. Alright, let's begin with Expressive Iteration. and bottom exile. Farzoth, thank you for the prime sub. Welcome to the stream. Do they have a Stubbidies? Breeding Pool Stubbity? Yeah. Yeah, Breeding Pool Stubbity. Now, I think I'm gonna try and risk the Preordain to find an Unholy Heat. We'd be very lucky to find it. Oh, I think I'll play this Channeler. Using all this treasure, but that's good. I don't think you have Sign of Draco. Do I have big plans for Berlino this weekend? Well, I was supposed to leave today after the stream, but strikes in Berlin airport made me delay to one day, so I'll fly tomorrow. That means, though, I'll have a small stream on Friday morning. That also means that I have to rush and do much more videos in 2 days instead of three. But it is what it is. Okay. Thankfully, I can't get the leader in my way, so they have to just loot. Wow, did this crash sign of Draco? Surprised. She just played Dress Down again with Kabu so popular. Let's play Dress Down again. Very strong gear. Let's go hand, bottom, exile. What do I want to Unholy Heat? I think I'll Unholy Heat the Wild Nakato to attack with Ragavan. Well, let's cast Nishoba Brawler. Chrome Flims is not as good. What can I find that's good? Lightning Bolt. Okay. Let's go face, 2-3. I also have my Lightning Bolts, by the way. Oh, I don't want any of those cards. Leave that there. I intentionally miss a land drop. See what they do. They start by attacking. Okay. I get to 9 here. I'm not dead to Treble Flames Bolt. I could that. Nah, they can't double Treble Flames. They don't have lands. The 3 cards. I'll Subtlety. The Kabu. And there it is, Lightning Bolt. GG, let's go game 3. Again, not an easy matchup, not an easy matchup. Very, very hard. There's a lot of cards I'd love to cut. Even the Questing Druid is bad, and Sped Pierce is bad. Maybe I want Underworld Breach. If there was Fury, I would have definitely had Underworld Breach, but there isn't Fury. They took it away from us. The Yawgmoth lobby has a very important influence on the Wizards ban list. Yawgmoth lobby is banning TikTok from the United States of America, too. Their power is going all the way to the Senate. Do you confirm? Put them all to 5. I'll kill the Ragavan, and I'll immediately Mishra's Bauble. I need to find a land. The Yawgmoth lobby is so powerful. I wonder what's the next thing that's gonna happen. It really could be anything, honestly. Maybe they can try to make Amulet a bigger band. That's the next play they can make. Alright, 2 mana 4, 3. Above average card. Lens. Fudinchi. I mean, Canister, you saw it. You saw what they're able to do. You saw what they're able to do. I mean, they made Violent Outburst banned. It's anything can happen at this point. Do I just want to draw a land off the top? Maybe. I just intentionally miss a play to draw a land. Maybe it's wrong, but let's do so. Nah, they can't ban Calderon. It's a 50 euro card from most recent set. There's no chance they can ban it. Oh, never mind. They just did it with Fury. I forgot. Yeah, they can. They can. Hello. I don't want to play explosives. Let's do this. Let's go Channeler Preordain. Multi-5 this game. Yeah, exactly. I can threaten a block. If I find a bolt, I just play bolt. If not, I can play channeler. Alright, I found the actual lightning bolt. Should have... Nah, this doesn't matter. An amulet before Yawg? Yeah, it's the Yawg, the Yawg cabal. I will play Bolt in upkeep. Go down to 12. If you have Stubby D, you have Stubby D in your hand now. Another bolt. Another bolt. Okay, I think I want to graveyard this. Hear me out. This card doesn't answer a 4-4 or Scion. And if they have Stubbity, I also have a block, so I think I don't want the bolt there. Your poison, okay. Poison has been picked. Ragavan dash. Okay, good thing there is no bolt on top. Hopefully for no bubble. Murktide. Oh, kaboya. Please don't have a fetch land. Nice. If they had a fetch land, this game would have been over. Over. Orvar. Okay, let's dash. Using the blue mana. I'll play 1 mana 3/3 and pass. I guess I wish I had a lightning bolt in hand now. I guess I couldn't because I would have stole it with Ragavan, so yeah. Everything fine so far? They trouble flames my Channeler to dash Ragavan. Okay. I can accept that. I have one card in hand. Land. Okay. Murkitty. Okay. I will just play Murk and Ragavan. No dash this time. The Ragavan Olympic is over. We're now staying back. I just clicked random buttons to delve with Murktide and it happened to be right. I'm dodging Tribal Flames and I'm turn two clocking you. No, pick your poison again. Okay. Ragavan dash. Alright. Block Shimas. And another one. I'll dash.
Welcome everyone to a new Legacy video.
Get command. Thank you for the raid. What you got? Lightning Bolt. Hold you and pass. Enjoy the games. Thank you. Yeah, these are it's always good games with Murktide. I could die here. Hope I don't die. Return Giganta. That's definitely not dying. I can tell you that. Okay, so I'm playing a Ragavan, which is obviously super suspicious, but whatever. And then I'll subtlety the Giganta. My problem was that if I dash Ragavan and they bolt it, it's annoying, because then I can cast subtlety. And Giganta is actually relevant, so yeah. Ragavan is an absurd magic card. It's a good card. They have to print good cards, right? And this one happened to be okay, somewhat. Okay, I'll still subtlety this. All right, we won. We beat Zoo. This is an achievement. Beating Zoo with Murktide is an achievement. Put a multi 5 and did an open ley line in 2 of the 3 games. That definitely helps. But this was indeed an achievement. Okay. I was supposed to just play one match today on stream and continue the league tomorrow, but I'm feeling it. I'm enjoying it. I'll play another match. I'll play another match for the stream. Yeah, Ragavan is supposed to be good. Like, if Ragavan isn't good, these decks aren't good. These decks may not be that good either, so it's... You have to have powerful threats to make this overpowered combo format a little bit more mid-rangey. I was pressing Druid in this list. I don't know. I found it once or twice with Surveillance. I always put it in the graveyard. But I played against Zoo, so, you know, obviously not good against Zoo. When Jackal Pop was a playable card, get command... Sorry. Commentaired, do you know that I played this format called the Pre-Modern? And actually played against Jekyll Pop 2 times last weekend. Last weekend I came 2nd in a pre-modern tournament. And yeah, I went with elves. And Jekyll Pop is very bad against elves. So I was always able to beat it. I really hope it's not a long match, because I was not supposed to start this match, but I guess I got hooked. That's what happens to... When you play Murktide, you get hooked. You win a match, and you're like, oh, this is the best deck in the world. Look how much fun I'm having. And then, I don't know, the opponent plays a turn to Grist, and you concede. Okay. Again, Gigantha. I swear, today I played against so much Zoo. It's crazy. What version of Elves am I playing? I'll show you in this way with the Mengus Workshop, the last VEEDEO, pre-modern VEEDEO. 2 days, 13,000 views. Very, very good.
Okay. I go. You can go.
The
returning.
Yes. It's with the survival.
Right. Grab Multinus Acolyte. I'll discard it again. And finally, I get a Musty Core. Okay, I go to draw step.
Happy here. Pass.
Are you happy?
Or you're watching this VEEDEO right now? Yeah, it's a great VEEDEO. It was very fun to play. Very difficult game. Are Zoo and Gorio's best deck in Modern? No, I wouldn't say so. The best decks in Modern are and will remain for a very long time Amulet and the Yawgmoth. Although, very high barrier of entry, so you need to know what to do. Alright, my opponent has a strong start. Unfortunately, I'm on the draw, which leaves myself with a... As I said earlier, Mono Black Coffers is a deck that loves to be on the draw. Murktide is a deck that on the draw struggles a little bit more, especially with Taplins now. Yeah. When I kept a Wallander, so there's a chance. Could have Stern Scolded the Wanakato. I would have had a. I would have been able to counter the Ragavan too. With Sir Scolding, which is supposed to be a side out in this match, it would have been very good here. If I never draw second land, I win.
Welcome everyone to a new Legacy VEEDEO.
Matarix! Hello! How's it going, my friend? You have a safe trip back home from Bologna. Me and Kai played against each other in the Legacy Four Seasons. And my editor is working on the VEEDEO that we made. So, yeah, eventually it'll be out. Hopefully 2 weeks. Yeah, we got some Questing Druid action today. One Questing Druid in my deck. It's in here. I'll cast it. Not great to cast it on empty board, but if I find a fetch, then I'm happy. I don't. That sometimes works. Questing Druid is a little bit clunky when you flip iterations or auto Questing Druid. We certainly can't flip auto Questing Druid because I only have one. Anyway. I have a spell to cast. Did I beat Kai in Legacy? No, I did not. I was defeated. He was able to get out of a, to me, what looked like an impossible situation, but he was able to get out of an impossible situation. Very, very skillfully, for sure, playing Doomsday. Doomsday is like the Amulet Titan of Legacy. So actually, I can play Murktide Regent, or I can play Unholy Heat. I think I can't play anything. I have to keep up Counterspell for Sign of Draco. If opponent resolves Sign of Draco, I die. any funny stories about my local LGS? I mean, I definitely say a lot of funny stories here on stream here and there when they come up. Right now, I am trying to win this game. I stumbled a lot, but still put me to 7 life with their powerful start. And now, I think I'm able to turn the corner. Go Unholy Heat into Murktide as big as I can. Counterspell up. What set is Record from? The one and only Modern Horizons 2. Actually, if you want to hear a funny story, when MH2 came out, this was the card I was the most high on. The highest on. I thought this card was broken, so that's so good. Turns out nobody played it until Leon of the Guild Fight came out. Alright. I'll keep on countering, of course. Thankfully, I didn't buy a lot of copies of this. I mean, I guess at the time. Ooh, Brazen Borrower. I love that. Definitely want to bounce now. Do I want to keep... I think I'll keep Iteration in hand instead of Pick Your Poison. Bounce the Ley Line. I'll Bauble. Tavu. Attack. He bought 4 of them, never played. I actually have never played them either, but I played them yesterday in the Mengus Workshop video. We recorded Amulet Titan versus Zoo. I played Amulet Titan against Zoo, so at least I was able to use the Sign of Draco at least once. Honestly, definitely one of the reasons for that YouTube channel, the Mengus Workshop, is to be able to use all the cards I purchase and never play. Okay, my opponent now has to, fetch, take a lot of damage, and still they don't have full domain. So they can't play Sign of Draco, for example. That is looking better than before. Yeah, could be. Actual Draco from Plane Shift. Yes, there is the combo in Pre-Modern that goes. I believe it's called Nostalgic Dreams. You put Drake on top of your deck in some ways, like Scroll Rack. Brainstorm is banned, so you can't use that. And then you go Nostalgic Dreams and you deal 16 damage. Oh, Insidious Dream. Erratic Explosion. Maybe it's Erratic Explosion. That's the card. Yeah, you go Insidious Dream, you put in a row Draco plus Explosion, and then you explode 16 damage. Yeah, that's the combo. Yesterday night, I practiced a little bit of, because this weekend in Berlin, I'll be playing a deck I've never played before in Pre-Modern, which is the blue-white, Parallax Wave Replenish type of deck. Last night, I tested a bit of that. That's not a very unfair deck, by the way. Legacy vibes, but no Force of Will in the format. Okay, my opponent goes Forest, Secret Foundry. Hello, Moose. Can I counter? I can't, unfortunately. This on the stack is a 3-3. Babine. Alright, I'm going Preordain, looking for a Lightning Bolt. I go Iteration, looking for a Lightning Bolt. Oh, I don't find any of those things. Okay. Even another Murktide would have been the win. We bubble me. Ooh, there it is. Okay, that's the win. Preordain. Draw it. Play Murktide. And attack for lethal. Okay. All right, we're in the zoo bracket, but we somehow are managing to get on top. My opponent doesn't have Leon of the Guild Pass. Oh, actually, they did have it, but they missed a second land. So it feels like if they have something that doesn't go right, we win. But if they go Leon of the Guild Pass and two lands, we lose. Yeah. So far, they never were. The game where they were able to go two lands and ley line, we lost. So the cards that are better, I think honestly, Questing Druid. Yeah, Questing Druid is probably worse than Stern Scolding. It's at least it pitches to Subtlety. Okay. Well, we have lands and spells. I don't even think when I open these hands. That's a great thing of playing mid range. You don't have to think. You just open a hand. You see lands and spells. You keep. If you play Amulet Titan and you do that, you're not gonna be having a good time. I tell you for experience. Because I did probably plenty of bad keeps with that deck. I just can't play those decks. Unfortunately, it's my limit. Leyline helps a lot though. Like, it goes painless. It gives you all the domain. I think I'll attack here. I'll take a 2-for-1. Kabu is very strong. I want the draw. I can take a 2-for-1. This is like going Fury. I'm using two red cards to kill one. I thought I'm using one new favorite. Yeah, it lasted a little bit, but after I lost too badly. I'm very, very quickly influenceable, is that a word? I'm very quickly influenceable. The moment I lose, I give up. There's just too many decks to love something too much in Magic. All right, this is a good turn two. Very good turn two. Impressionable. Okay, I like that. This is a very good turn two. Ragavan. Very strong. Always played on turn one. There's no more Brennan 6 in the format, and Orcish Bowmaster is very, very little played. Probably lowest it's ever been. Okay, opponent goes Treble Flames on Channeler, no land. Okay, I'll go Preordain. Bottom both. Ardcast Ragavan, land, go. I could have dashed, but I didn't feel it. I want to have a survey land. I want to get some card advantage with my Flooded Strand. I didn't want to go. I like this. Have I ever commented on the Twitter firestorm of touching cards? What does it mean, touching cards? Oh, that your opponent touches your card? Huh. What I do is something that I remember there was like a American player who top 8ed the Pro Tour, and he was always playing with these cards facing the opponent. And then they like banned that way of showing the cards. But it's something I do a lot. Whenever I play cards that I think my opponent doesn't know, like let's say at the pre-release, or even in pre-modern, when I tutor for something weird, like I tutor for Treble Force Mage or whatever, I just basically just hand the card facing my... play the card facing my opponent, or just cast the card facing my opponent. Oh, I think this is good. And I think that helps a lot. Like, you don't even waste time. And if your opponent already knows, they go, alright, I already know, fine, you just flip it back. But it's very, very common that they don't know if I'm doing that, because it's always like, you know, weird cards. It's not that I do that on the normal cards. Can I change? Yeah, thank you. Actually don't have anything left here. That's bad. Don't have anything left. And at the pre-release, I do it on almost every card. Like, let's say my opponent has shown that he doesn't understand my deck very well. So in order to be less confusing, you just do that. It's not that I do it very often. Can I? I misclicked. I should have had an upkeep stop. I would have graveyard this island. Yeah, it is what it is. Allora, sacrifice and artifact. Yes. Graveyard. Lightning bolt. Probably top. Wish I had Giganta Companion. Wish I had an upkeep stop to bolt. Would have been a much, much better spot. Ooh, Sign of Draco again. Alright, let's hope they don't have a Stubborn Denial or this game is over. But by the way, they tapped. I think they do have it. Yep. If this island was a... there's still no chance here. I have to draw like iteration into Murktide, something like that. It's a start. It's not iteration into Murktide, but it is Murktide indeed. And obviously just make it as big as I can. I don't care about like unbinding or anything. I got a 3. Now we got the game 3. GG. Close game. I thought I was winning easily. I guess I just flooded out. Yeah, I think I made like a preordain to like scry 2 lands on the bottom, draw a land, and then an iteration with 2 lands. Yeah. That's not ideal, but... and it's not very good. Very reactive, which is not where you want to be in this matchup. Okay, so top priority now is finding a fetch land. Yeah, people are playing with lands in front. Yeah, last weekend at the pre-modern event, also a lot of players were playing with lands in front. Alright, I'll bottom for sure that. This is free to keep on top. It's the same as bottom in it. With the difference that you have an object in the graveyard. So it's better. Okay, they go Ragavan. Fetchland? Nice. What's your favorite pre-modern deck? I play elves. I have spent a lot of money on making, on getting all the arts I like. With 14 beta forests. Which kind of doesn't make too much sense because beta isn't even in pre-modern. I just wanted to have it. I'll dig up a picture of the deck. There it is. This is it. Very, very old border. Yeah. Gorgeous indeed. I guess the next step is getting Beta Llanowar Elf. Which I saw yesterday for $200, 200 euro. Which is, I don't know, reasonable. Let's sacrifice an enchantment. Yes. And then destroy Ragavan. Go. €200 for four Llanowar Elves. And fetches pretty poorly in upkeep. Interesting. Okay. They don't have any mana issues. They can cast Cyan, but they can cast Kabu. Kabu here would be devastating. I would lose to Cyan here. Sorry to Kabu here. Okay, let's hope not. Okay, very good. Very good, very good. It's a little bit too many lands, unfortunately. Should have won game two. Did I punt game two, chat? I was so far ahead. How did I lose game two? Did I just get unlucky? It's so rare that you just get unlucky with this deck. Usually you always make a mistake if you lose a game that it doesn't feel like you should be losing. Kabu. Oh no, you drew that? Oh, caboya. Sorry. Well, we have a top deck here. Engineered Explosives. And we have a Surveillance to search for it. Engineered Explosives in two of. Nope. Just lands. These spell pierce should be taken out. What could I have instead of spell pierce? Counterspell? I definitely think Brotherhood End sucks in this matchup. Maybe I should just had a Questing Druid on the play. This is an uncommon game though. It's okay, good run. I almost thought I was starting the league beating double Beating double zoo. I thought that. I really thought that. That's fine. Alright, so opponent goes in big in combat. I'll bounce the Kabu. Eight to ten. They have four cards in it. One is Ragavan, one is Kabu. Hello. Let's see if I can draw... Ugh, not even explosives now. Okay, that's good though. Well, I'm on three. Basically dead, but I guess I can keep on playing. This pep is what was a counter spell. I would have been in the game. I would have still maybe lost to the Ragavan plus Gigantha. but I would have been in the game a little bit more. No, I'm on one life. I don't know what can happen for me to win this. I guess it has to be like Murktide into iteration into Murktide into a removal, something like that. They just flip Bolt and end me. Perfect. Yeah, they did flip Bolt and ended me. Alright, GG. Okay. I'll stop the stream now. I'll be back tomorrow morning to continue this league. So if you're watching on YouTube, you don't have to do anything. The video will be edited wonderfully, and you'll feel like it's the same day. Maybe I'll change the hoodie though. Who knows? Maybe not. Let's go. This is round number 3. I have a turn 1 Chandelier, which is slightly worse than the turn 1 Ragavan, but I'll take it. You built blue red scred in Pauper? Nice. Yeah, it's a good deck for sure. Brisket or pulled pork? I'm going to go with brisket. When it goes Island Preordain, I'm gonna try and get Delirium here with double Chandelier. Bauble? Almost. Bauble? Yeah, this is just a triple Chandelier. It's just... it's gonna be good. Maybe I have regrets with this island. It should have been a Steam Vents. Yeah, especially since I have Splashing Green. Yeah, the island should have been a Steam Vents. Hopefully it doesn't matter too much. Buongiorno. Also, let's hope they don't have Fire Ice. And Swamp. What is that? Pass. Okay, I'll play another Chandelier and attack. I don't think I want a Boldface. Although maybe it's a good play. They could have Orcish Bowmaster, I guess. Do you think if they had it, they wouldn't have played it? Nah. Let's just pass. Playing around Orcish Bowmaster. Maybe they didn't play, I don't know. Fairy Mastermind. Alright. I'll kill this with Unholy Heat and then I'll get Delirium. Hopefully I get Delirium. Hello, Delirium. There it is. Okay. I mean, I have to be in a Murktide region, but I think it's very much worth doing. Buongiorno, Pivo. What time's the flight? 1 p.m. 1 p.m. I can make it. All right. Guess wish I drew that Murktide region now. Wish I drew that Murktide region now. Yeah, I'll bubble you. Okay. I didn't expect double removals, but after turn 2 they took it off to play Fairy Mastermind. I would assume they would kill one of my creatures first. Okay, Bitter Blossom is interesting. So Bitter Blossom means that if opponent can't chump block, although I have two removal spell, plus Bitter Blossom is a guaranteed source of damage. I think I'm gonna let it resolve. So it used to be banned in Modern. Kinda crazy to think about now. I keep those in hand. Ooh, that's good. Faeries deck used not to be able to gain life, and Bitter Blossom is just a death sentence. I mean, especially when your opponent has two lightning bolts. Sure. two top permanent in the same turn is a rare sight. Doesn't matter too much. We have it. We're closed in end. In poker terms, we have the nuts. Okay. Quick. Second Murktide this week? No, I'm just continuing the league from yesterday. I'm actually 1-1. I guess I should put it somewhere. Don't know where. You're seeing my pre-modern video? Nice. Yeah, it's so, yesterday me and Tommy recorded another video. It's modern video. Allora, I'm playing against blue-black Faeries. Why only one Questing Druid? I mean, it's the 5th iteration. See, it is as the 5th iteration. And yeah, I don't think you need to play more in this format. That's the reason. I'm taking out Brazen Borrower. It's a fairy. I don't want the Brazen Borrower to think that he doesn't belong and he just joins the other team. You know what I mean? Be a problem. What do I want to do it? I guess there's maybe too many spell here. Too many stairs. Stern Scolding counters Fairy Mastermind, Spell Stutter. It doesn't counter the fairy, the Sleep Cursed Fairy. Good morning from Puerto Rico. Buenos dias, Puerto Rico. Buenos dias. Man, Breach might be actually very good in this matchup. But it's weird, right? It's because like they have removal spells. It's hard to sideboard. I wish I could just skip it. I wish I could just skip sideboarding and just have an AI that sideboards for me. You want a counterspell? A counterspell? Yeah, maybe. The black ley line. Oh, right. I didn't think about black ley line. Let's hope they don't have it. Man, this hand is clunky. And don't be like, Breeding Pool is making us lose. This would have been the third island in a normal version. I don't think I can keep it. I would say it's kind of unlucky, though, to draw the three islands. But yeah, whatever. Mulligan. Keep Shimas. I'll bottom an island. Go. Going best of one in arena or play a Carnegie Creator deck. That way you don't have to sideboard. I did like this Cape Shift deck. It's gonna be a video soon. It's just classic Scape Shift. Alright. Do they play Orcish Bowmaster? Man, it's just too tough, right? Because if I don't play the pass with 2 mana up, then they can go, I mean, whatever. I lose if they have Orcish Bowmaster. Ooh, that's true. Black Lay Knight isn't a nightmare anymore. We have Pick Your Poison. You are right. Don't play Orc. Chalice on one. Oh no, this is a nightmare. Pick Your Poison does not count as that. Eva Bean. All I have is a 1-1. Lord Beerus with a very large raid. Welcome everyone from Lord Beerus. What have you done, my friend, today? Have you enjoyed some magic online? Bitter Blossom. I wish I could disenchant that, but I can't because I have Chalice of the Void. Which I don't really have that many answers. Ooh. Key. Okay, I'll have to keep Murky on top. Right? That's my plan to win, I think. No, for real though. Like, what are my outs to that thing? I didn't even bring in Explosive Brotherhood. So it's just one Otawara. Ah, whatever. I'm all in. I am all in. Pick your poison. You sacrifice an artifact. Maybe you forgot your chalice trigger. They did not. Alright, Delirium. Attack. Go. I started out Borrower. I felt like my opponent's playing a fairy deck. I didn't want to have a fairy. It would be kind of like misplaced in my deck. I'll bolt my channeler. I'll bolt myself. Draw. Attack. And then I go fetch land. You went 4-0 in paper with Murktide tonight? Sweet! Surveil one. That's a 2-drop. Could have been worse. Allora, I need to exile 4. Battled by Yato, sorry. Alright, so the thing is that I don't want this to be a 1-1, but I also want to. I'm gonna have a sword. I have a sorcery. Maybe I just make it a 1-1 now, the channeler? Yeah, and then I'll they can ping it. They can ping it, but next turn with iteration is gonna be a 3-3 again. Yeah, I feel like they don't have orc. I don't know. I'm just not gonna play around orc. So I'll exile all the sorceries just to make this bigger. And then next turn, I'll play a sorcery and go in the Lyrum again. Because I have a iteration on top. This is probably like still like super losing game because basically my opponent just answered this and you know we don't really have a deck anymore with that chalice in play. But okay. Play iteration. What does allora mean? It's like then. It's an Italian word that makes you go to the next sentence. It's just thinking, like, you know, it's not nothing. It doesn't mean anything. Oh, you have a spell stutter. Okay. Now, if I play Murktide, I lose Delirium, but still is better, probably. Having a 5-5 that doesn't die to Fatal Push. Than having a Channeler in Delirium. Fatal Push can't be played. So they don't fetch end of turn makes me think they don't have the blue-black surveil land, which, you know, obviously should be in their deck. Alright, go Murktide, go. Actually, what if I cast this? Yeah, man, if I could get Delirium. If I mill a sorcery or a creature. Or an artifact, sorry. I think it's free. It's really not doing it. Oh, this is good, I'll leave it on top. It's not really doing anything in my hand anyway. I have like one Otawara in the deck to answer that chalice, so. One is a 5 and I have a subtlety on top. What is their hand? No, Field of Ruin makes me shuffle the subtlety. Rip subtlety. So no more Questing Druid. When it activates immutable attacks, makes me think of Flame of Honor, a card that's probably dead now that they banned. Ooh. I drew this, but the only green land is gone. That's unlucky. Alright, whatever. See what I find off of the Seek the Beast. I'll play Sorcery Speed. Again, I want to grow this, if it's possible. I need like a sorcery or a artifact. Yep, one is a 5. So this is the abyss at the moment. Okay. What is threatening a race over here? Let's see if they activate the mutable too. Hey, do 3, taking 2 damage off of Watcher Grave. Man, I'm not gonna block here. If I draw a sorcery or artifact, I have 2-3 lethal threats. What is that, to bolt? Yeah, it'd be a, it needs to be an uncounterable bolt though, which I don't play. Or incinerate. Finally enough, opponent is dead to incinerate and not bolt. Can you imagine that? Alright, go to 7. See what I draw. Actually, pick your poison would be a bad draw here. Because I don't have green land anymore. Volcanic Hammer. Yeah, Volcanic Hammer would be lethal. That play, you have one card in it, it can't be that hard. Just pass or play it. Like, come on. Let's go. Attenzione, Stern Scolding. Bella merda. Okay, let's attack with Murky. Reason for any Druid or Goyf. I mean, Goyf was just in a very small portion of the metagame where Rhinus was the most played deck. But, it, yeah, you shouldn't be playing Goyf without a lot of 4/4s around. Why am I playing Prague? I wish I know. You can check out the Porco Dinci. You can check out the podcast. Will you let me draw? What if I draw a freaking counterspell? Did you bubble me? Why don't you cast this in your turn? I had no cards in hand. Ma porca madosca, ma guarda te, Dio caro. Buta, it's bad? Bad news? Okay. Go! Now leave upstairs Scolding just so that if they play a spell I can trigger Channeler. You thought for like 20 minutes and then play this in my turn. Like, just play in your turn. You activate the Creeping Tar Pit. Okay. Six. Oh, that's on a 2. Okay, they play. I think that's a borrower. And then I surveil one. What do I want on top? Another. What do I want on top? Let me think, because it's important to think about what you want a top deck. Let's go with an iteration. Okay. Play on top. Play. You have to manifest the top deck, otherwise it doesn't appear. So I have Delirium now. What do I want to find off of this? Another Murktide, I think. I really don't have that many outs. What can I find? I started out like everything. There's nothing in my deck. I guess, am I dead on board? I'm dead on board. I need to find exactly a Murktide. Man, I shouldn't have played this pre-comp. I guess I was dead on board anyway. Yeah, I was dead on board anyway. Yeah. I think there's nothing I can do here. There's nothing you can do. There's nothing I can do. It's over. What if I just attack with that? I stuck with both, but yeah, I'm dead on board. GG. We have lost Creeping Tar Pit. We can say that. Not a sentence you say every day, but we said it now. We have lost to Creeping Tar Pit in 2024, not in Cube. La 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 la. Okay, we got game three to go now. We have plenty of answers to Chalice. The question is, which one of these do I want to play? I want to put in my deck. Got some one drops. I don't want Brotherhood. Maybe these two. What happened? Oh, also cast Subtlety. Nah, Subtlety go come back in. One Subtlety is in. A land and a dream. That's like sure preordain. Okay. I'll bottom Unholy Heat. I have enough of those. Go. Surveillance are nice. Yes, indeed. Okay. Unfortunately, we miss a land drop. But that's okay, given we kept the one lander. Can't complain. But it doesn't fetch end of turn. I respect my stifle. I'm gonna do the end of turn Questing Druid, hoping to find a land, but expecting the worst. It's not the worst, we find Island and Bolt. Okay, that's good. Oh, oh, there's Island Bolt face pass. Yeah. Yeah, you must splash pick your poison. It answers all the problems of this deck. Urza Saga, the One Ring. Ledger Shredder, Murktide Regent. Pick Your Poison is as good as the Surveillance in this deck. You must play them. The only reason why you don't play them is because you don't want to buy a Breeding Pool. There's another Chalice on one. Yeah, yesterday in the podcast, we were talking a lot about Pick Your Poison and praising the Pick Your Poison. And Javier and Anthony said, like, this is as pushy as you can get. It can't get better than this. And I said, no, they can make it uncounterable, so you can kill Chalice of the Void, which actually came up in my Legacy and also in this league as well today. But in Legacy also comes up. It can also be an instant. Yeah, that's true. It can also be an instant. But the uncounterable would be better if I had to choose. For Chalice of the Void, it's... In Legacy, Chalice of the Void is a bane. Chalice of the Void is as oppressive as Wasteland in Legacy. You have Ancient Tomb and Siege of Traitors and Lotus Petals. So a lot of decks just pull it out in turn one before you can even start playing. Isn't the best thing, but it is what it is. Eccolody. Chalice of the Void. Va bene. I have a Counterspell, I'll play it now. They can't go Spell Stutter Sprite, which is nice. They'll probably just go Counterspell. I can borrow it and see what to do, but once again, we have our quite unfortunate timing of this Pick Your Poison, which can't answer the card, which is not great. E guarda lì, porca puttana. Do I play Questing Druid? Do I want to run some cards? No, right? Into the Chalice? No, I don't want. I decided in a couple of answers to Chalice. I could have had more Bitter Blossom. Va bene. End of turn, I'll attempt to bounce the Chalice. Oh no, now Spell Stutcher now counters the Borrower. Oh, I guess I can't subtlety it. Can now, but that one is very good. I'll do this pre-attack, so attack for two. I pass. Destroy my Greenland? Yeah. Yeah. You know what I can do. Yeah. Now I don't have green anymore, so this is dead once again. That's on zero. Bauble, perfetta proprio, guarda lì, porco. E you can go. You're 10. Bitter Blossom puts you to 9. Maybe I should move here. It's just that I think they have a Spell Stutter Sprite. So I just don't want to move. Like, I'm winning this game, so I don't think I should move. The question is, though, do I want to... No. I don't think I should move. No. Because there might be a world where I successfully bounce this Chalice in one with Borrower, and then I want all of these in the hand. This is not like game two where I was throwing this away to pump the Questing Druid, because I knew I didn't have any out to Chalice. Now I have an out in hand. This is I'm playing around the spell stutter. Oh, and I have at least subtlety up. They concede. Alright. Maybe they had in hand a bunch of fuddle pushes. I don't know. But yeah. No creeping tarpit this time around. The old Murktide Regent. Underworld Breach wouldn't have done that. But Murktide succeeded. Wonderbeals Giganta, this may be the third zoo deck in four rounds. I hope it isn't. And also, as always, they have Ley Line, Desta Minchia, Porca Puttana Eva. Va bene. Now, I know they can play Nishoba Brawler, but. Underworld Breach inside is for Yawgmoth. And yeah, I would also side him in against Omnath and Control. Yeah. I think, like, the option of them for... I think I have to play Counterspell. The option of them going Nishoba Brawler isn't worth the 3 damage, because I can also go Sign of Draco or Kabu. So I think I should have kept... I think it's fine what I did. Silver, we have a podcast about Modern, so if you like to listen to what we think about the last ban, you should definitely check it out. It's called Competitive Magic with the Carnies. Alright, but it has to respect the counterspell. I don't draw. Don't draw the removal spell. I'm playing a single Ragavan there. But I'm shocked and didn't get Giganta, so they have a spell, for sure. I think I'm gonna counter it. Like, I'm not gonna say this is the right play, but I just have 2 mana up and I think I must use them now. I'm going down to 6. Obviously die to some trouble flames, but can't do much about that. On the draw against Zoo, who started with Leyline, you don't win if they have normal draws. That's a lot of brawlers. Bella. Okay. I mean, Brotherhood that obviously looks insane against that, but it's just not that... I think it's only good against that particular card. Otherwise, it's not very good. Yeah, I think I like this up here, Stern Scolding. We started the league yesterday. We were 1-1. We just defeated Blue Black Faeries and down a game against Zoo. Okay, good end. I mean, this is land Ragavan on the play. It's always a good end. Storm's Breath. Storm's Breath. Nah, well, 4 mana for this deck is... Like, I was dead. It was turn 4, I was dead. I guess if I had Storm's Wrath, I wouldn't be dead, but I don't know. Oh. Okay, they have Leyline. That's okay. Physic like Bazaar of Baghdad. They always have it. I think now it's reasonable to fetch for Island in this matchup. Plus, I have another card to play after. Just greater than anything I find here. So my problem is that they have two ley lines. If they go Cyan, neither Explosives or Borrower answer them. So it's gonna bottom both. The card I look for is Pick Your Poison. Please don't go Cyan. Don't go Cyan. Okay, that's not Scion at all. Should I take a draw? Or play an Unholy Heat in upkeep? Nah, I think I'll take a draw here. Bauble. Unholy Heat. Play Preordain. Okay, that one is okay. It's not the best. I definitely don't want another iteration. Then I bubble. Do I want to have a bubble myself? If I find like a... Yeah, I'll bubble myself. Okay. But yeah, if I found some information, I would have played it untapped. Although, I guess unlikely it would have happened. So maybe I should have just bottomed them. But sorry, bubbled them. RA. I mean, when they don't do Leyline plus Saya, the game is winnable. Like, they have Binding in hand, sure, but... It's not impossible here. I find, like, two threats off of this iteration. Okay. So they could go Binding end of turn if I go Channeler untap land. Do you think they will go Binding end of turn if I have a Pierce in my... If I have an untap land? Actually, I can't have an untap land, never mind. So let's go easily. Hand, bottom, exile. I'll play Channeler. I'll play Bauble. Surveil. Yeah, I'm just not gonna... I don't want lands anymore. Now I think I want to Bauble me. Once again, if I find a bad card, I can go Thundering Falls. If not, I can go Spirebluff Canal. Find a good card, I go Spirebluff Canal. Bolt. What do I classify Bolt? I think I classify Bolt as a bad card now. What is the good cards? The good cards are Murktide Regent. Four iterations. What are fetches? Deck thinning over there. Okay, there was another Bolt under the Bolt. I think they're Binding in hand. They may not. They may not have Binding. Oh, they do. It's a white mana floating. And the Binding. Okay. The Seal 16, playing Leyline means that you save like, I don't know, 9 damage from your fetch land. Hand, bottom, exile, and then I'll start picking your poison on these ley lines. Keep this for Sign of Draco. But I guess I have to start somewhere. Yeah, maybe one regret I have is that I bottomed the iteration with Preordain long time ago when I had two in hands. I figured it wasn't a way for me to run out of cards, but there was actually run out of cards here. Didn't find a Murktide in top 30. This is similar to how we lost game two, if you remember, of the first match. I thought it was unlosable, and then somehow I flooded, and they just played creature and killed me. Played Gigantha, mostly. So, yeah, this is something that has happened already, and I don't want it to happen anymore. I guess I should have this idea in mind that, because, like, you think of Zoo as an aggressive deck, so you bottom with this extra iteration, like the third one, when I didn't even cast the first one. But I should think about more of it as a slower matchup or sideboard. Yeah, we're out of Pika Poison. I wanted to play them to unlock this eventually with the third one, but I guess I could have saved it for Sign of Draco. Definitely some regrets in this game. And we ended up flooding quite a bit now. Could have kept those Pika Poison. I mean, I have four spells in hand, and I have zero. All right. Tough loss. Okay, last match of the league. I am on the draw. Yeah, twice seven. That's what happens when you lose the games that you should have won. Magic gives you mulligans. Okay. At least there's not the best start in the world. Land a Wyrmite. Sailors, thank you for the 7th month. Agatha Soul Cauldron. At least it's not Orcish Bomanzo, but yeah, very good that too. I'll cycle this iteration. Maybe I find Mishra's bubble. I don't. Christ the Hunger Tide. Okay, let's put that in the graveyard. Okay, and bottom exile. Man, if I did a mulligan to 5, maybe this game was winnable. Go on, draw bolt. Nah, I think I need to put everything in the graveyard because of Murktide. Okay. Slightly better. Let's attack Grist. Face. I attack face. My opponent is going to tap the cauldron for sure. And I annul the heat in response to the Grist. What about the annul the heat on top? This is just a shock. Actually, I'm going to graveyard it. It's just a shock. I don't have delirium. And I just, again, want to put more things for Murktide. I pass. Now, I guess I just cauldron the Grist. If you cauldron this becomes one loyalty. Next turn is two loyalty. So I still can't minus on Murktide. Maybe the Unholy Heat wasn't that bad after all. Don't think I want to bounce the cauldron. Cauldron doesn't do anything so far. I think. So I'm making 8-8. And keep up counterspell. And I just went into attacks here. Yeah, now they just got insects. I got a bunch of insects. I got two insects. This insect makes insects. They actually... Okay, ooh, thank God it didn't plus first. Or they could have, like, exiled the Yawgmoth with Grist, with Cauldron, and proliferate to kill my Murktide. Oh, wow, I just got three loyalty, because they even exiled another Grist. Okay. The problem is that they found another Grist. They milled another Grist. So they have the win now. I just have to hope they make mistakes. But they have the win now. Well, I pass. I have to bounce this one. But on green mana, nah, Life Toad might actually be relevant in this game. By they have the win, I mean they can kill my Murktide, not actually a win. I guess that Unholy Heat was needed. If I had Unholy Heat, it would have been a different game. I would have cast it end of turn on the Hayward Might, and I would have bounced the Ogatha, and they wouldn't have it. Yeah, exactly. They're doing it now. They proliferate. Yeah. By proliferating, they can now minus two and kill my Murktide. Yeah. Yep. They saw the line. I mean, I tried. I mean, I'm out to 5 this game. It's not that I was having a good time. But yeah, basically, like, your plan is just Murktide hoping that something goes wrong with Grist. That's why I have Pithing Needle, because Grist is very good. Although, this is the first time ever I'm trying this Underworld Breach plan. Let's see how it does. I've never tried it before. A bounce Agatha, they replay it, exile the Grist, and their insect has 3 loyalty. Have you missed Bloodman so far? Is Bloodman good against Zoo? I don't know, maybe it is. Cursed Totem of Needle. No, Cursed Totem is not a good card. I'm anti-Cursed Totem. Pick your poison, exhaust the cauldron, but it's kind of about it. Maybe we just need one. That's as much as I can do. Maybe I should just trim Murktides. I didn't think about it. I should definitely trim some Murktides. I don't want to cut them all, though. I still have the Pithing Needle on Grist, and the Murktide is a very good card. Alright, I'll have a random Brazen Borrower. I think Pick Your Poison isn't too good. I mean, I understand that it does kill the Scaldron, but... Soul Guide is here for the Graveyard decks. The Gory deck. I don't even know why, if it should be, but... I saw it in Piegonte's list and it made sense. Land Halfling, Preordain looking for a Bolt. Bolt. Nope. You opened 1,000 play points in a chest? That's good. Sick. Yeah, I remember last time I opened a treasure chest. There it is, that's the bolt. Classic clunky Brothers who'd end. Maybe I just played them wrong. Alright, let's bolt this. See if I got Delirium. That's Delirium, not yet. I'll agree with that. I'm gonna go Preordain. That's good, I wanna draw it. I guess I wasted it. Whatever. Yeah, maybe it was bad. I should not have drawn it. What am I looking for here if I graveyard this? Opponent's gonna go, well, Langrist. Let's graveyard this. Looking for... Perfect. Yeah, I was thinking about Iteration or Underworld Breach. I mean, I tried Storm's Wrath in the past when Rhinos was the most popular deck. Now I don't think you should anymore. Rhinos is there, but it's definitely not the most popular deck. Okay, what if I draw Subtlety here? Because I have Counterspell up now and then Subtlety the next turn. That one cannot resolve. Okay, I'll leave that on top. Maybe a mistake. I really dislike Brotherhood. I really always disliked. I mean, that's why I didn't play at ERC, because it was just bad in every matchup except the one where it's really good, and it never tests against the one that are really good, like Arden Scales and Hummer, and then I got paired against Hunter Scales and Hummer, and I didn't have Brotherhood. And I lost against them. And that was my RC. But 9, end of turn, I'll surveil 1. Draw. I'll play this thing. Fortunately, Endurance survives. I didn't have another light burn spell. I think this is another game that I was supposed to win. Like, I had all the cards to win, but then you just draw like 3 lands in a row and... Okay. Preordain is a good top deck here. Very good top deck here. I'll, go top. Play Otawara. Play Bauble. Bauble you. Draw Unholy Heat, cast it in upkeep. You play Young Wolf. I think I'll go for a Subtlety. Just because I want to attack. You're 8. Draw a new card. How good is this? I guess it's a divination. I'll play it. Conceding. Is this a lag? Okay, concede lag. Okay. Last game. I mean, it was better than divination. I would have flashback double preordain. Last game. I mean, we went to top deck mode and we drew Preordain into spells, and then we won. If we drew, like, the top deck mode against Zoo, where we drew land, we would have lost. Like, yeah, I mean, I guess if you don't play your early game too well, you can get to the late game where you just have, that. Okay, on the draw, what if I take out Channelers and just have no win conditions? What do you guys think about that plan? What do you guys think about that plan of having no win conditions? Except, yeah. Maybe it's bad, but I gotta try. Let's have some random one-offs. Pulling a Nassif, nice. What's the Nassif pulling? The random one-offs? Or the no-win conditions part? Alright. I keep an unplayable hand. When it goes land, Delighted Halfling. I draw Pick Your Poison. Maybe not very good in my deck, but we'll see. Murktide. I think that's an easy graveyard. It's gonna help my Delirium. I have like no creatures in my deck, so if I already have land and creature, it's a good start for Delirium. Calderone? No, Apatra. Thought that was a Calderon. It's a lot of people in play. Somebody give me an Anger of the Gods. I'd love the gods to be angry. Bottom top, and I just shoot down the Apatra like this. Apatra does value. I don't want my opponent to have value. You don't know about this plan. Nah, same. I'm just here to test. And by test, I mean play a random game and see how it goes. Not that I actually test. But, you know, you can think of it as a small test. I'm gonna attack with Halfling. Do they have Endurance? Terra, e che cazzo. Alright, I mean, I did do it myself by keeping a 5-lander. I don't want to play Iteration there. I feel like, yeah, I gotta wait a bit more. Okay. Oof. Ugh. My hand is so clunky. Does it get better now? No, not at all. I wish this was a Dragon's Reach Channeler instead of Sta Merda, but it is what it is. Hand, bottom, exile. I'll go Unholy Heat here. And I think I'm gonna go land Pithing Needle on Grist. Then I can cast Pick Your Poison on Pithing Needle now. Yeah, maybe Pithing Needle isn't a good sideboard anymore. Now that they have Pick Your Poison. Yeah, it's not. It used to be a good sideboard card. Now it's not anymore. Lost Calderone. That's fine. Even if they exile us a card in the graveyard, I still have Delirium. And we even have Pick Your Poison for the Calderone now. Yeah, they pick my poison. So that I can pick your. Something? Man. I guess that Pick Your Poison for my channeler, but I really wish I had channeler. Just 9-2-1 ones. Crazy. I'll Otawara this Dried Arbor. Creature. Kamadelsk. I have to pass. I need to find what I don't know what I can find, honestly. Just dying to 2-1 ones. Younger of the Gods would have won the game. Not would have won the game. Would have not made me die. The game would have been longer. You don't stream due to Berlin. I'll go after this match. I pack up and head to the airport. Tio caro, ma guarda te la Madonna. You have Anger of the Gods inside. Yeah, no, I mean, it makes sense now to have Anger of the Gods inside. Yawgmoth is the clear best deck in the format. Maybe before you were like, oh yeah, I should edge against Armor Time, but like, alright, I think I have to do this. I mean, it's a terrible play, but I have to do this. I have to bounce and counter a young wolf. Like, you didn't. You never want to do that play. The thing is that they have like 4 spells in end. It's not. They have nothing. Yeah. Any Preordain could be anything. Maybe Storm's Wrath. Yeah, but I'll continue the survivorship. Grace is a 1, Young Wolf is a 2-2, I got a 3. What's it called? The Underworld Breach would make me win this game. Let's draw Underworld Breach. I'm gonna tap out with Borrower. If they have a Cord for Endurance or Endurance, that's fine, I'll leave. But I have to attack the Grist there. I can play around anything. Yeah, they have Cord for Endurance. Okay, I think now I'm Stone Zero outs. Is a Drazi Winter coming back in MH3? Maybe. They have the new Drazi, right? The 2-2. Bella, GG. 3-2-3. Usually I do my weekly 3-2 with these leagues. Today we did one step behind. I did play against 3 Zoo deck, which is quite an unfortunate matchup. And I feel like I could have even won if I had played slightly better in some of them. But nonetheless, average Mengu league for sure. And not too many takeaways from this. Outside of, you can't play Pithing Needle anymore. I always dislike this Brotherhood end. I really always do. Like, sure, it's good against Armor Time and scales, but like, yeah, I don't know. Like, why people would play them still, but I guess they would, so you still have it because it's a bad matchup anyway. But maybe now that you pick your poison, you can do without. I don't know. It's just a card I've never liked. What else? What else to say? Bah, we're all, classic Murktide. I mean, if you like it and you have to play it, it's probably still a decent choice. But, you know, nothing fantastic. We didn't play against Cascade. Maybe you can cut Flusterstorms. I don't know. Yeah. You can go more all in on the breach plan, have one more breach instead of all the Murktides. You can try and find a plan that sides out all Ragavans and all Channelers. My opponent, Dressdown would be decent, yeah. My opponent has never played any Orcish Bowmaster in this match. I still lost, which is not great. Anyway, I will edit this match together with the league yesterday, upload it on Sunday. You probably watched there. So yeah, if you did the whole thing, thank you for watching. I'll see you tomorrow, next Sunday, whenever it is.